Innovation is the cornerstone of success in America. In order to compete in the global marketplace, businesses and individuals are continuously striving to stay ahead of the game. I'm Terry Bradshaw. You know, from emerging technologies and financial strategies to the latest healthcare developments, you would be surprised by the many factors coming into play. Welcome to Today in America. Although it doesn't look like much is going on inside this furnace, the metals inside are actually undergoing a complex metallurgical process. While most metals appear the same, there are thousands of possible alloys, each existing in dozens of different heat treat conditions. Heat treating is subjecting metal components to certain temperatures and chemicals for a specific amount of time. These conditions dramatically affect the metal's property, from being so soft you can twist it into a pretzel to hard enough to drill through other metals.
Well, heat treating uses two different methods. One method, we heat treat the entire cross-section of the material, and that doesn't make a chemical composition change. The second method is where we surface harden, where we may add carbon or nitrogen, and that's called nitriding. That's one of the fastest growing technologies in heat treating today.
Now, in just the last 30 years, computer-controlled technology has completely transformed the process from a mixture of science and black art to pure science.
Over a span of a few decades, the heat treat industry has evolved from a smokestack era of an environment of open fire furnaces with flames, bellowing smoke and soot, to a highly sophisticated process equipment that is safe, clean, and quiet to operate.
It is mainly through our improving understanding of metallurgy that car engines have gotten lighter and smaller, while at the same time becoming more fuel efficient, powerful, durable, and more reliable. Without these advancements, the 100,000-mile car warranty would not be possible. The same applies to airplanes, TVs, surgical instruments, virtually any object that uses or contains metal.
The initial chemical composition and the subsequent heat treatment of steel determines the positions of various atoms in the crystal structure of the alloy. That in turn determines the properties, mechanical properties of the steel. These phenomena have only been understood in the last 100 years through the usage of modern testing methods such as X-ray diffraction or electron microscopy.
Nitrex is the network of commercial heat treating operations with affiliates in manufacturing and offices around the world, including North and South America, Europe, and Asia. The manufacturing companies supply OEMs and service providers in the metal heat treating industry.
Nitrex specializes in the manufacture of sophisticated heat treating equipment, designing instrumentation, writing software, and even providing heat treating services. In addition, we have open symposiums where we invite academia and industry to discuss the latest in nitriding technology, a technology that's the fastest growing in the last 30 years.
Nitrex's main operations are based in North Las Vegas, Nevada, in a 20,000 square foot facility that features furnaces, control system, parts, and a metallurgical lab. Because workers skilled in heat treating are hard to come by, the company has developed on-the-job training methods, organizing and archiving the know-how, general improvements, and automation of equipment.
To the best of my knowledge, there are no college degree programs for heat treating professionals in North America. Both from the supplier side and the customer side, heat treating professionals come from metallurgy, material science, or engineering.
The world of metallurgy continues to experience major changes and advancements every day.
The possibilities with metals are practically unlimited, and Nitrex will continue working on further advancements in metallurgy. Our contribution to educating the industry is very significant, and we intend to stay on the cutting edge of heat treating and metallurgy for many years to come.